Would you like to experience real-life bank reconciliation issues? Well then stay tuned as we do together the second consecutive month of bank reconciliation in QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. In the second consecutive month that you will reconcile an account in QuickBooks Online, you will notice the following issues. First, you will notice the unclear transactions from the prior month appearing on this month's bank statement. Now we will mark them as cleared. When we finish, the little history link in the top right will have an additional report for the second month's reconciliation. And on top of that, I purposely planted a mistake in the February statement so that you can watch exactly what we do step by step when we find a mistake when we're doing bank reconciliation. Now here we are in the statement of the second consecutive month. The first thing you may notice is that the ending balance of last month from the previous video when we did January is equal to the beginning balance of the February statement. What we want right away is the ending balance of the February statement because that's the first thing we put in, the ending balance and ending date. So back in QuickBooks Online, we click the cog wheel, we go over to Tools and click Reconcile. Now, I lost my chance to put in the ending balance and ending date because I was preparing for this video. But you will have a field that you can put both of those in. I would have to click Resume Reconciling and click Edit. You see, I had already put these in and moved forward, and QuickBooks Online didn't let me go back. But you can put them in now and then click Reconcile or Continue Reconciling, and you will see we're at this window. Now, you can click the Don't Bother Me box if you want the help to stop popping up. And you may notice in this month, we have both deposits as well as payments. And you should click all because the format of the statement I'm giving you is the more challenging format where the checks and deposits are mixed and put in date order rather than separated for your convenience. It's better to learn on the harder format so when you go on the job, it'll be a breeze. Now we're going to mark them off one by one exactly the way we learned in the previous video. So the first one we're looking for is the $1,000 for check number one to Con Edison. Do we see that here? Yes, we do. We mark it off and the cleared balance changes. The next one we're looking for is check number two for $550 to Rex Repair. Oh, wait. Before we move on, remember, as soon as you check it off in your QuickBooks Online, change the color in your Excel file to indicate, yes, we've marked it off in QuickBooks Online. Now let's examine check number two, 550 Rex Repair. It is there, so we mark it off, and then we tell Excel that it is in QuickBooks Online. We do that by clicking the highlight. Now let's examine if check number three is there for $500 to Staples. Yes, it is, so we mark it off, and then we tell Excel that it is, in fact, in QuickBooks Online. Aha! Look at this one, Candy Charles, $2,100. Guess what? This was an outstanding deposit from the previous month, January, that cleared in February. When we look closely, we see that this $2,100 from Candy for sales receipt number 5 was actually recorded in January, but it did not clear the bank until the beginning of February. So it is a legitimate deposit. We mark it as cleared and then tell QuickBooks Online that it cleared the bank. Now, what about this check or this electronic transfer to Rex Repair for $1,000? Well, seems to me that that matches here in QuickBooks Online, so we're going to tell Excel by marking it off and highlighting it. Oh, look at this. This is another one that was outstanding at the end of January that now appears on the February statement. This $300 from Candy, let's take a look. This $300 from Candy was actually received in January, but it wasn't recorded by the bank until it cleared at the beginning of February. So it is legitimate and we mark it off and then we tell QuickBooks Online, there you go. Now keep going because you're going to see a surprise. The next one, check number 4 for $500, does match. The next one, so we got to make it blue to tell the statement that it's equal in QuickBooks Online. The next one, which is an electronic transfer for $200, is that in QuickBooks? Yes. So if it is, we mark it off and then change the color on the statement. Stay with me for another moment. Okay. The next one, $800 for Verizon. Yes, that's also in QuickBooks Online. Okay. And let's change the color because we just marked it off in the QuickBooks Online. UPS for $900. Is that in QuickBooks Online? Yes, it is. But now wait. Aha. Check number 7 for Staples in QuickBooks Online is $500. But when I look at, let's mark this blue. When I look at check number 7 for Staples in the statement, it has it for $800. Stop right here. Check number 7 on February 14th for Staples was $800 on the statement, but check number 7 to Staples in the QuickBooks Online is $500. So what exactly do we do if we find a difference? Well, our QuickBooks Online shows the February 14th check number 7 to Staples as $500. But the bank says check number 7 on February 14th is $800. What do? We look back at the original check to determine who's wrong. And the bank should be required to send you a photocopy of the check with the statement or by special request if you didn't keep a copy for yourself. Once you have the copy, notify the bank and request a corrected statement. After receiving the corrected statement, start reconciling that month from the beginning. Now, if we made the mistake ourselves, we don't have to do steps 1, 2, and 3. If we were the ones who made the mistake, all we would have to do is go and correct it in our QuickBooks Online records and then come back to the reconciliation window. But if we look at check number 7 for Staples, we can see clearly that the bank made the mistake in this case, and in this case, the $500 is the correct number. So let's imagine that the bank gave us the correct statement. And if we take a look here in Excel, we can now jump over and see that the bank gave us a corrected statement wherein, let's just zoom in here, wherein check number 7 is now $500 and there's actually a different ending balance as a result of the correct amount of the statement. It's a good thing we caught that. Otherwise, the bank would have basically stolen $300 from us. That's why we do bank reconciliation. You can see that the new balance is $300 more. It's like earning $300 because we're responsibly doing bank reconciliation and catching the bank's mistakes. So now we have to go back to the beginning and start all over. Now the way to do that is remove all the check marks, yes, select all, and then click again to remove all. And when it comes to edit info, edit the information and change the ending balance to what the ending balance is on the new corrected statements, which is this amount that we're going to paste in here. Now, yeah, get rid of the dollar sign so you don't have a problem. And then click Save. And now start from the beginning, marking off everything one by one. Now, you can pause the video and try the rest of the bank reconciliation yourself. If you are successful and the difference is equal to zero, then you could fast forward past the matching part that I'm about to show. But don't worry, there's a little bit more to discuss at the end. So don't quit the video, just fast forward through the matching part. But if you're unsuccessful, then you can unclick everything again and rewind the video and follow along with me step by step. So let's go ahead and do it. Now, here we are back in the statement, and we're checking to see if check number one for $1,000 is there, and I happen to remember that it is. Okay, so let's mark it in blue. Check number two for $550, is that here? Yes, it is. So we'll go back to the statement, and we'll mark it in blue. Check number three for $500, is that there? Yes, it is. So we'll check it in QuickBooks Online, and in the statement, mark it in blue. Remember this one? This one was from last month, but we know it's correct and it cleared this month. Oh, it's up here, actually. It's up here, sale receipt number five for $2,100. So let's mark it in blue. What about this one? $1,000, this transfer to Rex Repair? This $1,000, this transfer to Rex Repair, is correct. So we come back to the statement, mark it in blue. What about the $300 for the receipt for candy? Yes, it is. It's here. That was one of the ones that we wrote in January that didn't clear till the beginning of February. So we mark it in blue. What about check number four for $500? That's correct in both places. So we click it here and we mark it in blue. What about this transfer? You know, sometimes the only thing you have to go on is the number or the money amount itself. But we know that there's a minus 200, so we check it and mark it and highlight it in both places. What about this Verizon for 800? Yep, that's there. Click, let's scroll down a little bit. Good, we're making progress. Mark it in blue. Highlight the next one, minus 900. It's there somewhere. There it is. It's a payment for 900. So if we check it here, then we mark it in blue. Let's examine check number seven for Staples for 500. Is that there? Yep, looks like it's there. Check it off and mark it in blue. What about this UPS check for 800? It's there. So if it's also 800 here, we check it off and we mark it in blue. What about this check number eight to Staples for $1,650? Looks like check number eight for Staples is $1,650. Click on it and mark it in blue. We're almost done. What about check number nine for $150? Check number nine for $150 is here. Remember, they're not going to be in the same order because they don't clear the bank in the same order in which we recorded them. But it's still there. So we mark it in blue. Three more. Deposit from Candy for 2,000. Is that there? 2,000, going once, going twice. Okay, there it is. Remember, it's not the same order, but when we find it, we click on it and we mark it in blue. What about for Alan, this 3,000? Is that there? Yes, it is. We click on it, come back, mark it in blue. Now, the most important moment. There's only one left on the statement for $600. And at this moment, $600 is the difference. That means at the moment we mark the very last one on the statement, that's the moment that we click it here and the difference becomes zero. Notice, We have two additional transactions that we recorded during February that were not on the statement. And because they're not on the statement, we will not mark them off in QuickBooks Online. These will probably clear in the next consecutive month. But the crucial moment was the moment we marked off the last one. That was the moment everything the difference became zero. So we will click Finish Now. Click, actually we want to view the report. Here's the report. And if you click Done, you'll actually come back here. And now let's take a look at what this is and see what the history would look like after the second consecutive month. The history is simply a list of every prior reconciliation report for this account in QuickBooks Online. It can help you see exactly what happened in prior months. So we can click History by Account, and we can see that it actually breaks it down by year. I'm recording this video in 2020, but I just went back and did a 2017 reconciliation. So if we had any in 2018, it would be listed here. The 2019 reports would be listed here, and so on. We can open up 2017, and now we actually see two reports. This is the report that was made when we did last month's reconciliation, and we can look and see what was going on exactly at the moment we did last month's statement. Now, this is the new report that we can open and see all the details of what's in our records at the moment that we did this month's reconciliation. We can click and view the report, take a look at the categories and how everything is broken down. So if there's any kind of difference, you can isolate exactly which category the difference is in.